What we're seeing on the screen is the pendulum engine of the Argentine engineer Eduardo Taurozzi. As we can see, the piston is curved and runs on a toroidal cylinder. If you are looking for more power, it can also be built in V. Or if not, put many cylinders in line. This engine is a machine with low thermal losses since there's very little friction. Its inventor knew that his project had to leave the blueprints and become a reality, otherwise no one would believe that this engine could work. Without further ado, he got to work and first built a go-kart that could drive on the highway at 70 miles per hour without difficulty. In this prototype, he saw that his ideas were on the right way, since the engine produced great power without even heating up. He decided to take it further and build a car engine with parts from a Fiat 128, where he took everything he could, such as its cylinder head, crankshaft, among other parts, and placed its pendulum pistons. In addition to obviously building a curved block, which is relatively easy to do, he welded the block, refilling it, and then used a curved boring machine. Obviously, this engine is four-stroke and performs the processes the same way as intake, compression, expansion, and exhaust. It uses the same firing order as any four-cylinder engine, being 1, 3, 4, 2, and results in 30% fuel savings at the same power levels. The same engine he built for the car went to the car fair in Argentina in 1996. It was exhibited to the visitors who came by. Big automakers like Mercedes-Benz were immediately interested. Leave your like, subscribe, and I'll tell you what happened. Okay, first, we'll see how it works in detail. A conventional engine has a straight cylinder and a piston that runs through it. This piston must be high to avoid tipping over. This tall piston produces a lot of surface area that rubs against the cylinder walls. In addition, the movement of the connecting rod means that at times it is at a very aggressive angle and friction is increased. This causes the cylinder to wear out of an oval shape. No matter how tall the piston is, there's always minimal pitching. The only way to keep this controlled is by using a lot of oil in this sector. Now let's move on to the pendulum system and pay attention to the differences. The engine has a crankshaft as usual. The connecting rod is also the same. Then we have the curved cylinder, which is correctly called a semi-toroidal cylinder. The piston is one piece and has a fixed banana-shaped arm. This arm is attached to a shaft on the side and uses bearings. The function of the arm is to ensure that the piston is always kept in the center and avoid touching the cylinder, making the friction theoretically null. Since there is no friction, the wear of the piston is zero. All the great force that the arm uses to keep the piston in the center and previously occurred on the piston walls is now discharged through the bearings on the shaft. As you know, bearings are very good at decreasing friction and are far superior to the direct contact that occurs with a piston and cylinder. For there to be compression, the cylinder is sealed using conventional rings, which receive less oil compared to a conventional engine, so no oil ring is used. While the piston arm is weighted, it should be noted that the piston is now skirtless, because pitch is controlled by the arm. This results in a very short piston, and ultimately the weight stays the same. Although the most important thing is that friction is reduced, which results in 30% more power and fuel economy versus a conventional engine. It should be noted that the banana-shaped arm is only responsible for keeping the piston in the center. The main power, the product of burning the fuel, is discharged through the conventional connecting rod to the crankshaft. The refrigeration system is also smaller due to the low amount of losses, using smaller radiators and less coolant, further lowering the weight. Taurozzi became a fan of his engine and installed it everywhere, even on his own lawnmower. He also released two-stroke versions, which, since they had no friction, consumed very little oil, meaning there's no smoke. But if this engine is so good, then why isn't it used? Well, actually, it is used, but not as an engine. There are Taurozzi pendulum compressors, which are responsible for compressing special gases, such as those used in medicine or laboratories. These compressors are frictionless and therefore do not require a single drop of oil. Since there is no combustion and the temperatures are lower, the rings are made of self-lubricating Teflon, making it ideal for compressing gases of the highest purity without being contaminated by oil. For example, pure oxygen, which then does not require any treatment to remove the oil. There are factories in Argentina that build these compressors. One of them is Taurozzi, and they mass-produce them. As for the motor sector, the result was different. He patented the engine in 1974 and mailed everybody. Initially, it received several interested parties from Asian brands, from Fiat, and even from Mercedes-Benz, who at that time was also working on a Wankel rotary engine and was open to new suggestions. Firstly, they ignored him. Then he built the engines to catch their attention. But in all cases, the brands said the same thing, that his tests were fraudulent, that the engine on display was specially prepared and ran with advantages against a normal engine, among other things. They also said that it was impossible to mass-produce curved cylinders, but the reality is that there are hundreds of Taurozzi compressors today and they're still being manufactured. Also, Taurozzi's personal car still exists. Today, there are also no patent problems. That is, this pendulum engine was patented in 1974, and after 20 years, the patents are released and remain in the public domain. Anyone can take the idea and monetize it without paying a cent. For more than this, Taurozzi continued trying to promote his engine. Even though he won't be getting any money, he just wanted his lower emission engine to be used to help humanity. He only succeeded in the compressors where his benefits were proven. As of today, this motor is over 40 years old and its inventor is close to 80. I do not want to say that the automakers are bad or that there's a conspiracy. I personally did not find any paper that endorses levels of power or consumption. And today, it's very easy to bench an engine. There are hundreds of dynamometers available to rent for 1 hour. But maybe, for Taurozzi being 80 years old, it's simply too much for today. The reality is that this engine can be classified as a rotary engine that combines the advantages of a piston engine and a toroidal engine. The toroidal motor was originally patented about 100 years ago, where you can see the pistons are inside a donut-shaped cylinder. Taurozzi also played with his toroidal engines and patented many of them, but he prefers the pendulum. He built four inline, V6, and boxers. In 2015, the government of Russia used the Taurozzi toroidal version of the engine and promised to create cars, but until today, nothing happened. If you like the video, you can give me a super thanks for the value you like, although you can also help me by liking the video and commenting what you think of the engine. It's always good to review the comment space because many people contribute their knowledge in that section. And don't leave without subscribing for more videos. See you next time!